Alright guys, welcome back to another Warframe video. In the last video, we were pulling Rhino out for the first time in a while, and we were doing some work on Steel Path, specifically on Saturn. Got to test out a new augment mod on Rhino, and made really, really good progress. It's always fun pulling Rhino back out. But today, we are going to continue trying to work our way through some of the frames we've had just collecting dust in the vault there. Last time I did one I've kind of had for a while. This time I'm doing one of the newer ones I've picked up. And we'll just keep rotating older, newer, older, newer until we get through them all eventually. We still have quite a few to go. But today, I'm sure it's obvious just looking at it. It's a very immediately recognizable frame. This is going to be Xaku. So I've already got them visually customized. And I've got the kind of stance that they have customized, but I haven't jumped in to read the abilities, so that's what we're going to do. Let's just start by reading the abilities. I've seen quite a few people using Xaku. Xaku looks like they are probably pretty good, but let's just read through their kit so we can see what's up. Passive 25% damage reduc on AoE attacks and chance to avoid incoming weapon damage. Huh. So there's a 1 in 4 chance that their shots don't hit you. That's actually pretty cool. Alright, so Zada's Whisper. Wield void damage for all attacks from equipped weapons when activated. Oh, so that gives a base damage boost. I wonder if that scales with strength like Rhino's Roar. 20 second duration? That's not a bad duration, actually, all things considered, and the drain isn't that awful. Grasp of Loke, Void Tendril, steal weapons from nearby enemies to use as your own floating auto-targeting armament. That sounds silly. Damage output increases based on the enemy level. Okay, so probably pretty good in Steel Path then. Number of weapons grabbed also determines the damage multiplier for the lost. Denies Void Beam. For the lost, denies void beam. Ah, okay. The lost is the 3. All right, drains 50. Grab range 6 meters. Duration 5 seconds. Max targets 3. Range 5 meters. Damage 20. Void damage. So I'm not sure the significance of void damage, or if it's just does extra damage, you know, based on other stuff you have in the background. I guess we'll figure it out, but it sounds pretty interesting. Okay, the Lost. Cycle through a trio of Lost Warframe powers. Accuse manifests a void fissure to corrupt enemies into allies. Gaze grasps target into void tendrils to capture damage, inflict it when the target is released, and then deny annihilates with a beam of void energy, wiping sentient resistances. Oh, wow. Okay, so this is a frame that would be good to bring against nasty sentience. That's good to know. All right, so accuse turns them into allies. Gaze captures damage, and when they're released, it does the damage back. Then deny annihilates with the beam of energy that also wipes out sentient resistances. So it's deny looks like it does a pretty healthy bit of void damage there. Gaze does a defense reduc. And accuse is the one that turns them into allies, okay? And you can take up to 5. So 3 on the turret, 5 on the accuse if you want to utilize that. Then we have the Vast on Time. Temporarily shed the outer pieces of Xaku in a destructive blast. Then stalk in a new, swifter skeletal form. Enemies damaged by the body shrapnel are rendered weaker to void damage, okay? So there's a lot of synergy in this kit. Xaku's other abilities, duration is frozen in time and resumes once the Vast Untime expires. Interesting. Duration is 10 seconds. There's a dodge chance there, so that kind of plays into their passive a bit, it seems. 10% slow, 600 void damage, range is 10 meters. That's a pretty big drain. All right, so I'm going to take a minute. I'm going to read through Xaku's tips. As soon as I'm done with that, we are going to jump in and we'll start cycling through the mods. All right, guys, so I just finished reading through the tips for Xaku. Sounds like a pretty involved frame in terms of just having to remember the various synergies. I'm guessing time in the saddle will just make that second nature over time, but they do sound like they're probably going to be quite a strong Warframe, and it did specifically mention that strength is what scales the number of targets you can do with accused, which is from the Lost. Yep, that's the one that turned them into allies. So there's a little bit of bits and pieces in here, which kind of plays into the lore since they're made up of broken bits of other Warframes. There's some stuff in here that sounds a little similar to some other things, like, say, Revenant can, you know, basically turn enemies into allies effectively. Or maybe it's Nyx. I forget. There's a few Warframes that have some kind of similar abilities. But either way, this sounds like it's probably going to be a pretty strong Warframe. Which means maybe they're going to feel a little bit squishy, so survivability is probably going to be key. But we're just going to jump in. We'll start with our base modding, just, you know, what I read. Obviously, we'll make some adjustments as we get to come through here. But let's start with, okay, so energy siphon, I think, is what I want to throw on there. Yes, it is. So that'll help keep a little energy up. They're slightly faster than the average on sprint speed. Their energy isn't super high, so I know I'm going to want to get a primed flow on here to start, because they sound like you're going to be casting at least reasonably often. So yeah, that's going to eat a big chunk in the pool, but it has to happen. So void damage. Void damage and void damage. So it's all void damage. So there's no real synergies with any of the base damages, which I guess is fine. Ability range is probably going to be important, but we know we need some strength on here. So let's start with, I could go intensify or umbral intensify. Being that I don't have a matched polarity on a slot anyway. Where's my umbral intensify? That'll at least throw a little additional strength in the background. Let's see what additional strength does to their numbers on their kit. So that bumps up to 23 extra damage. So they feel like a frame that maybe getting a Tau Forged Crimson in might be a good thing. Additional damage on Grasp of Floak. Max targets on accuse. Okay, awesome. The defense reduct on the gaze and even more damage on deny. And then the vast on time that bumps damage up as well as increases slow. So, yeah. We're definitely going to need to get some efficiency on here, but I think to just start, I'm gonna keep maxed flow at a little additional damage output there. So we're not gonna really have points to throw anything else now. This seems like a frame that I'm probably going to want. Oh yeah, I can throw a potato in there right now though. So let's do that. Let's see if we can just get streamline on now. Of course, that's not going to match either, but we do need efficiency on. What's that lower the cast on Zada's Whisper? 17.5. That's a good drop. That'll cut it down to 70. Yep. That's a big one. The Lost 52.5 is the drain there. So, yeah, that's, they're going to be energy hungry. 35 on Grasp of Floak. Okay. I'm curious to see what I think about them being in Vast on Time, and it says you can cast them in and out kind of at will. Duration also seems like that's going to be pretty important on this frame too. So they don't have high health or high shield or high armor. It's kind of middle of the road. So I'm thinking Equilibrium probably wouldn't be a bad one to get on this kit, but possibly throwing on this Rolling Guard that I picked up, just to buy them a little invulnerability. I think I am going to try that. And yes, I am eventually going to get that max, but I have it in a couple other builds that's going to require me to form a and then remaster a frame. So that leaves us with 9 more points for now. We've got our prime flow on. That's the one that we want. Strength, that'll lower duration, but I do want to get some duration up. That'll just lower the range. So what's the range of these? Range is 10 meters on the vest on time, 5 meter radius on accused, 6 on gaze, quite high on deny. Grasp of loc, 5 meters. And Zada's Whisper just applies to your weapons. So narrow-minded will give more duration, but that will lower the range. Let's just see what that does on the duration here. 16.3, that's a big bump. Duration 8.15 on the gaze and 8.15 on deny. Grasp of loc takes it up to 8.15. Yeah, that grab range is quite low. So I guess I could just make sure that I'm up in a pretty close proximity if I want to cast some of this stuff. But it is a trade-off. So that also lowered the max targets. Let me take that off and see what it does there. Max targets are 3. So it looks like having range plays a part into the number of enemies you can grab. Where's my stretch? That would take up 9. So what's that bump this up to? An additional target. And it bumps the range out a bit. So yeah, maybe I'll see if I can get a duration mod on here by itself for that quality of life, and we'll just deal with it in the immediate here and now at the base. But I think that's where we're going to start. We're going to start with the setup and see what we think about it, and then we'll come back and start making some tweaks as we get to actually put a little time in the saddle with Xaku here. So arcane slot, yeah, I'm feeling like an arcane energizing. Yes, again, same thing. I use this for background grinding when I'm just mindlessly, you know, farming for stuff, but I want to test everything legitimate the way that I earned it in game. So we're going to throw the base level energize on there, and then an additional slot for them. I guess they're going to be kind of sort of weapons heavy, especially with Zada's Whisper. So I could maybe just go for, actually, you know what? Let's just go multi-augmented. Strength buff. That's the way we're gonna think about this. We'll deal with duration later, but it feels at least like a reasonably balanced starting point. So that's where we've got Xaku, guys. I'm gonna quickly read their abilities one more time, then we're gonna jump right into Sanctuary Onslaught. So quick refresher here for me. Zada's Whisper, that adds void damage to weapons. Grasp of Loc, it's the turret. The Lost has the cycle, so Accused seems like the one that I probably want to be using relatively often. Gaze sounds like it could also be useful, but all of these sound useful, but I think that Accused is going to be the one that I would use the most out of the three. And the Vast on Time, I know what that is. Okay, so I've reread them again. We're going to pop straight into Sanctuary Onslaught. And let me pop it onto public. Not that it matters on that, but I am going to tick it off of Steel Path just for the immediate here and now. Pop right in and see what Xaku's all about. Okay, so we can start with Zada's Whisper to get some void damage on our attacks. Which it's honestly going to be a little tricky to tell what this is doing in early levels of Sanctuary Onslaught. Grasp of Loke, that'll do some turret action. Okay, doesn't last a super long time. But nonetheless, it still feels like it would be a useful ability. You find yourself getting surrounded. Yeah. Definitely seems useful. See what it does on an X-Men. I did nothing. All I did was cast Grasp of Loke. Of course, there could have been somebody that ran up behind me on my team, which is totally fine. But this does seem like a useful ability as well. Even though it does have that shorter duration. They're looking pretty good, guys. They're looking pretty good. Just off the cuff. All right, we've got our three unlocked now, which means we've got to cycle through. How is that cycle gonna work? Whoops! Gracias. Deny, accuse. So I guess we cycle through and then we tap. I'm not exactly sure how to get that ability out, guys. I'm a little confused by that. It wasn't tap and it doesn't appear to be hold. Oh, it is hold. Okay. And what did that accuse is the one that I wanted it on, okay? Yeah. Alright, and that's the radius. Yeah, I mean, the radius isn't huge, but it does work. I guess we could... Whoops! I was gonna say we could... cycle through a different one if we wanted to. What in the world is happening? Oh, I went down in midair is what happened.
Okay.
Do not weep for these creatures. They are immortal. They can and have faced a billion deaths. You, however, do not enjoy the protections of synthesis. For you, failure has real life consequences.
Those guys are annoying. Stealing your weapons. Let's see what Gaze does. Invalid target. So I'll have to find... Okay. And then when that breaks, that'll throw the damage back? Is that how it works? Yeah, actually does a good bit of damage. Okay, what about the next one? What about deny? And then when they drop out, what happens? Not much, they just get slowed. So yeah, accuse does seem like it's probably the most useful of these, at least off the cuff. I'm guessing that Xaku's gonna feel a lot better as we continue getting ranks on him. And here we go. We've got their four up now. It doesn't last the longest amount of time in the world, it seems, but let's see. It wants us to cast four followed by Zada's Whisper to deal more damage to the enemies. Okay, so yeah, getting a little duration on that would make the cast to cost probably a bit more beneficial. But again, not hating it. Hello, ally. For just a few seconds anyway. So yeah, it's getting the length of these up that's gonna make this kit feel a lot better, at least on the surface. That's how it feels to me. But it is a pretty interesting kit. Will you be my friend, Grineer? Will you be my friend? Looks like they will be. Yeah, getting the duration up on the turret would be quite nice. Alright, Xaku's up to 12. Making pretty good progress. So I'll probably just get them ranked up in here, guys. I've got to test out their entire kit. So I'll just get the rank ups, I'll back out, and then we'll move on to some real world testing. Alright guys, I just got done getting Xaku ranked all the way up. You know, first go around, I'm sure I'm going to form it at some point. So now we're just going to be focusing on where to put the rest of the points. So Grasp of Loke seemed to be quite good. I just wish it had a little bit longer duration. So I'm going to see if I can focus... not a narrow-minded, but something else that would increase duration. I forget which one it is. It's not flow. What's the name of that ability? Continuity. All right, that's going to eat up a bit, but that's going to give us some more time. A Grasp of Loke in particular, I found that that would be quite nice. Also gives us extra time on the big energy cast, the Vast Untime. On the Lost, it plays a little bit of a part in there, obviously, Accuse, Gaze, Deny. So getting a little additional time in there is going to be nice. I haven't really felt like the range was that big of an issue on anything that I was just testing in the base Sanctuary Onslaught. So it's feeling like strength and range are kind of the big two here. Duration, I think just putting the additional duration that I put on there is good enough for me. Obviously, I could swap some other stuff off, but it would end up costing me some of the number of the weapons that I could steal. I've got it up to a max of 8 now on the turret. That's a really good ability. That in tandem with Zada's Whisper, I would say, are probably my two favorites. Everything else worked just fine as well. No problem at all. But the one thing that I did catch the best use for this was to put the duration timer onto Grasp of Loke. So that is kind of a nice boon. So if you can get Grasp of Loke up, get Zada's Whisper on, so it's doing that additional void damage, and then pull the Vast on time, it really was doing a good bit of work on crowd control. And I played in some where it was getting some pretty good high-level enemies in there. Next thing I guess I ought to check, I don't know if I have anything. I do. Okay, so Vampiric Grasp, that's the Grasp of Loke. When the Stolen deals, what does that say? Damage affected by the Lost Gaze with the Vast Untime, you heal by 10. That will be a good survivability perk. So I think I am going to throw that one on. Especially since I'm trying to use it in tandem with the Vast on Time. I think that'll help with survivability here. And it just says deal damage to an enemy. Doesn't say eliminate, just says deal damage. So I think that's going to be a good one worth considering at least. And let me look at their other augment mod. The Lost. The Lost gains 5% ability strength, ability efficiency when cast. The effect stacks up to 3 times. Casting the same ability back-to-back resets the effect. Okay, so the Lost is... Yep, the 3. Now, the 3 I wasn't using as much, so I think at least for now I'm going to leave that off. But I at least like knowing that I have it there if I want to bring it in. This one, to me, at least seems what would be at least the most baseline effective, because I can get a little healing in the background while I'm doing my thing. So I'm just going to try that out. And then really what would be nice to get is, yeah, I know that would take duration down a bit. But, of course, if you cast their 4, it kind of negates the duration. Yeah, the timer on the duration. So maybe I don't need a continuity. Maybe that's a wasted slot. Not really sure. And their energy is up high enough that I didn't really feel like, you know, it was that big a deal. I guess what I'll consider is that wouldn't give me enough points to put the big transient fortitude on, which I would really like to have. Yeah, unfortunately, they've only got a polarity that doesn't seem to be super useful for their kit. Yeah, lowering range. Lowering range doesn't really seem to be that important. I mean, I guess I could throw them a little additional armor or something. I could get shield capacity efficiency. Efficiency is always going to be nice. But so is strength and armor. I can get strength with Archon shards, though. I think I'll go for a little additional efficiency just to get it up there. And that'll drop the cost. Yeah, down to 55 on there. Down to 27.5, 13.75. That seems like a pretty reasonable balance to me. I would really like to get a transient fortitude on here, but even my lowest cost... Do I even have a base transient? I think I only have those two. I could throw a little strength on there, and it would take off 15 of that efficiency I just put on. Of the 10 that I threw on from the hatred? Nah, that'll take the entire efficiency off. But it will make them stronger. So let's see. That takes it up to 43% extra damage. Yeah, that's kind of nice. Extra damage. Vampiric Grasp. So that gets health up. So health seems from that seems to scale with strength. Yeah, that really does do quite a bit more damage. Yeah, that's so strength. Yeah, maybe not duration as much, because I can offset that just by casting their four. I can put the pause on all of my abilities by going into four, and that's on a 25 second duration. So it would really be the duration for the vast on time is the biggest consideration, but efficiency I also really like. Rolling guard was useful, but I feel like I would rather have something else on in lieu of rolling guard. I might consider swapping the polarity on that slot to throw, you know. I think more efficiency, but of course that'll drop the duration on the four, which the whole point of kind of that balance was to get, you know, 25 seconds isn't bad there. Maybe I won't screw with the duration anymore. Maybe I'll just, anything else that can help me get a little more efficiency. We've got Streamline. That got counteracted by Blind Rage. But of course, if I could get a Transient Fortitude on instead, the duration would drop, but it would add way more strength. And then that wouldn't offset the efficiency that I gained from Boreal's Hatred. I'm just going to leave that for now. We know we're going to come back here and we're going to form us some slots. Plus, I'm guessing there's some Exilus mod that could be at least kind of sort of useful on them. Sprint speed is always nice to have, but I have also been liking, take your pick, any of these walker ones, the greater parkour velocity and aim glide. It's been quite nice. I've been playing around with that on Dante, and I've rather liked that as just a little side thing in the background. But nonetheless, that's going to be our point here. So we finished Onslaught. We got them ranked up. We got some more points in the till. I think what I'm going to do, I'm going to go test them out in Zariman, like I've been doing the last few, you know, first impression new frames. So let's just pop into the Zariman, go to Chrysalith. We'll say Calm. I will swap it on to solo once I get over here. Exterminate, plus we get a Void Angel in here. Okay, this will be a good test. I didn't see a timer on that one. Don't know how well or not well this is going to go, but we're going to try it.
Welcome to Boarding party. Grenier clones. Half rotten already. Wipe them out.
I just did catch it in the nick of time.
No flagging! You're my favorite little meat!
Just a little more energy and then we're gonna move up. That's about half, so... There's one left back here. Yeah, I like having the timer paused on the duration for all of their abilities when you're in your core. And I can do this for 25 seconds. So it just keeps buying me time. Yeah, I gotta say, once you get Xaku ranked up and you can start getting some more useful mods on there, you feel really good. Where did they go? There's some back here. Couple. Yeah, having to only focus on one ability cast to keep everything else that you threw in the till up, that's a really nice perk of this frame, I gotta say. A really nice perk. And I'm still rolling with the initial cast of their two and their one. What is that that's hitting me? No idea. And I still got 0.4 seconds, so it's still up. Actually awesome. Yeah, that's a strong ability. Okay, so we'll have to jump in here now, do this. Bubble. There's our Void Angel. We'll finish taking out these last few little ads here. and then we'll go for the Void Angel thereafter. Yep, I should have seen that coming. I kind of needed to push up though and get that done. Doing the Void Angel with this big room full of enemies would have done me no favors.
You broke them. Nice. Keep hitting them hard enough, and eventually they get it.
Okay. So, I'm gonna head back in here now. Now I'm gonna go for the Void Angel.
Was a dormant Void Angel. Now, it's not dormant anymore. Trying to retreat into the
okay.
Bullet so, it can
so far so good.
Follow it and stop. You can't hurt it while those dimensional orbs are out. Use your void body to absorb it.
Really? Come on, come on, come on. Where did it go? That's actually, that actually just did me a favor. Go.
Now it'll stay.
Yeah, I knew that was gonna hit me. It's totally fine. We'll take it down and we'll get through this either way. Far away. There we go.
Yes! It won't be shrugging that off.
And there it is. So we'll pick up our plume and we'll head out. So yeah, guys, take some tweaks, but Xaku feels like they're going to be a pretty strong frame here. I mean, I definitely like their kit. I like the way they feel, and I am positive I don't have this optimized yet. But just on the surface, yeah, totally fine. Getting through some harder stuff. Obviously, that's not Steel Path difficulty, which I will, of course, test. But in the immediate, what I just experienced, that felt great. That properly felt great. I really like their kit. It's a very unique kit, a very interesting kit, but it seems like a very powerful kit. So I think that Xaku here has a lot to offer. I wasn't sure exactly what to expect. You know, I've seen a fair few people using Xaku, but that's a fun frame. I like its kit. Once you get in and kind of get to play around with it, it makes a bit more sense, like, how you want to use it. And I'm thinking my idea of, you know, focusing full strength to just make it hit even harder. Efficiency just for quality of life, but duration really just for a little extra to give a little more time on the vast on time. And then you can pause the timer and everything else. That is huge, guys. That is a massively, massively powerful perk. Because that keeps you from having to recast and burning through your energy, almost to the point where maybe having that much energy in there using is not going to be that important. Of course, if I took it off, it would drop, you know, to just a tick over half of that number. But I definitely am a fan. That's a really fun kit. It's a powerful kit. I think we can make this much stronger. I definitely see the potential in this one right away. I see the potential. I don't think this is one that's going to take a ton of work to get worked up to be really nice to be able to get through some Steel Path content, but we'll find out in the next video. I'm expecting I'm going to have to come back and I'm going to have to forma it at least once, maybe twice, just on a few key slots that I want to have in there. But my first impression, overwhelmingly positive. This feels like a very strong frame, and it's got a very interesting and unique kit that I can't wait to dig into a little more. But guys, that is going to do it for today's video. Awesome, awesome new frame. I'm really liking this one. I see the potential there, and we're going to get to test it out further in the next video. But that is going to do it for today. Guys, as always, I do sincerely appreciate you checking in, and we will catch you on the next one.